All right, that about wraps it up. You now have a working app, some basic code, and an understanding of how to build some very fancy Connect apps. Now, there are a lot more things you can do in the JSON. Have a look at the plugin guide and you'll see many more things that you can do. There's just a wealth of parameters in there and a wealth of things that you could do. But now you have the basic tools to go out and build these on your own. And in summary, I'd like to just mention how much easier it's going to be for you if you do this in manageable sections like we have in this course. So first, familiarize yourself with the target system's APIs. Get everything working in Postman up front. So use a tool like Postman, exercise those APIs, get through authentication. That's always the toughest thing. Figure out authentication, and the APIs are pretty easy after that. Then translate your Postman calls into working Python code. Now remember, you can't use request here. We do have a feature request in to get that added. But in the meantime, you're going to have to use URL lib, so just keep that in mind and build them in that fashion. Then you need to map out your return values that you're going to get from the API calls and map those to the internal counteract properties and preface those with the word connect so you know what you got. Then you're going to build out your basic app, build a minimal system conf and property conf, and a very basic Python resolve script setting static properties to be returned. You don't want to make this complicated at the beginning. There's all kinds of things that can go wrong, so just build it basic. And then you can just add things on as you go, and you can easily tell where you broke something. Then build a working test script and validate. Then you'll know for sure you're talking directly to the server. Add in your working Python code from step 3 to the basic resolve script from step 5. Add that to your app, and then debug it all as one big package. Finally, if you want a policy template, you add the policy template group and policy templates as needed. You create some of those fancy little icons so everything looks great. And then there are many other things you can do, like adding an action script like we did in the example. I hope you enjoyed this. Have a fantastic time developing your apps going forward. Bye now.